So now for the competition. Presenters, your 3 minutes will begin as soon as you begin speaking. Timers are right here on both sides, and if you exceed 3 minutes, as you know, the air horn will sound on the timer and you will be disqualified. Let's keep that from happening. Our first finalist for this evening from mechanical engineering, Akanksha Menon, speaking to us on transforming waste heat into electricity.
We all agree that waste is bad, and yet over 60% of energy is dumped into the environment as waste heat. Most of this is at low temperatures, such as the pipe on your water heater at home or the tailpipe of your car. We can recover some of this heat and convert it into electricity using devices called thermoelectric generators. The issue is that the current technology is very expensive. So we sought a low-cost alternative by using plastics that can convert heat to electricity. In this demonstration, our first step was to determine how big of a device do we need to make. So I did a lot of thermal modeling to figure out what shape would be ideal. It turns out, to convert heat to electricity, we want a device that's radial, as you can see in this image. You can draw an analogy here with solar cells that convert light to electricity using silicon as a semiconductor. In my work instead, I'm developing semiconducting plastics that can convert heat to electricity. The best part is these can be formulated into inks and printed into devices. This is what enables it to be such a low-cost option. For the device, you can think of it as a stack of DVDs consisting of alternating layers of the semiconducting plastics. The best part is that because it's radial, it fits on easily to any existing heat pipe, since all of them are cylindrical in nature. So how do we build this device? Well, I like to think of it as an arts project, because you start off by cutting out disks out of paper, and then you print these inks onto the disks, and you can produce small amounts of power. In fact, I worked with a team of 3 high school students who were able to build this device and demonstrate that they could charge a small sensor. That's really pretty neat when you think about the fact that it requires no high temperature processing or machining, since all your innovation is in the ink that we develop and this radial design. That's what enables it to be so low cost. An added benefit of using these plastics is that they're lightweight and flexible, as you can see on the image. So you could imagine applications beyond waste heat recovery, such as using your body heat to power your smartwatch or Fitbit, or even having fabric that generates electricity. So if we could harvest all the waste heat around us with these devices, we would have power where we needed it, and it could be a game changer for energy efficiency. Thank you.
Thank you, Akanksha. Let's give the judges a moment to deliberate, and then we'll move on to our next speaker.